So in today's matchup, we have King Ghidorah versus the Mind Flayer. And this is a matchup that is a fan-requested matchup, and I really had to think about this for a long time because I did have to watch Stranger Things Season 3, but after I watched that, I actually found out I didn't need to watch that because the Mind Flayer really wasn't in that exact season. It was actually something different. But as far as this matchup goes, I definitely think it's a very interesting matchup. This is very different from basically all the other matchups I've done because the Mind Flayer is not just like a creature. It is very complex. And so I will definitely try my best to get everything accurate to the show, but there is a lot of stuff that is kind of unanswered and can be very confusing. But as far as these two creatures go, King Ghidorah stands at right around 500 feet tall, and the Mind Flayer, there's no exact height, but is definitely very tall, and really, I don't think there's even a limit to how big the Mind Flayer can really get. A similarity between these two is they both have a storm going with them, and I found this very interesting that King Ghidorah, whenever King Ghidorah flies around, a storm follows it, and with the Mind Flayer, it's always in a storm. And I found that very interesting, that similarity, that King Ghidorah has a Category 6 hurricane right on top of him, and the Mind Flayer has that red storm always near him, which is very, very interesting. Something, like I said earlier, that would really change this matchup and really make this a matchup totally different from every other one I've done is that, as far as my knowledge goes, this fight would have to take place in the Upside Down. And I know in the movie, Will is possessed by the Mind Flayer at one point, but really, for this to happen, the Mind Flayer would have to possess King Ghidorah and somehow take him into the Upside Down. And that's where they'd have to fight. Either he'd have to go to the Upside Down to fight, or the Mind Flayer would have to try to possess him, which I really don't think is possible, because video in particular I watched that someone was saying that obviously in the show, the way to beat the Mind Flayer, get it out of Will, was to really heat up the house to make it to where the Mind Flayer can no longer live in the body because it likes it cold. And that's very evident through the show. The Mind Flayer actually did try to possess King Ghidorah. Obviously King Ghidorah is massive, so that would definitely be a lot more tricky than possessing one little human. But as far as it actually goes, King Ghidorah can fire lightning, and lightning is very hot, and you even see the charging ability, how King Ghidorah is able to charge up. And I really can't imagine that the Mind Flayer would be able to possess King Ghidorah. Lightning is very hot, obviously, it can burn right through things, it can disintegrate people, and the actual loading up of the lightning makes it to where I just don't see how it's possible for the Mind Flayer to want to possess King Ghidorah or even be able to in the first place. The way I see this fight actually going down, if this happened, is if King Ghidorah was in the real world and suddenly, just like Stranger Things with Will, he walks outside and suddenly King Ghidorah is suddenly in the Upside Down, turns around and sees the Mind Flayer in the distance. That's how I imagine this matchup happening. King Ghidorah looks off in the distance and sees this massive creature just in the shadows with the storm, and King Ghidorah would stand off, and with how agile and giant and deadly King Ghidorah is, there's just no way the Mind Flayer would be easily taking him down or possessing him. And with how the Mind Flayer is, though, you don't see any actual real damage done to the Mind Flayer. Really, the only way to stop him is to close the gate to the Upside Down. So it would definitely be very interesting to see if King Ghidorah decided to fire the gravity beams, what that would actually do to the Mind Flayer. I think it would have to do something. It would have to be somewhat effective, especially with how the lightning is hot and it doesn't like the heat and likes it cold. And I definitely think that if King Ghidorah was flying around, and as far as we know, the Mind Flayer cannot, flying around, firing the gravity beams, and just getting up close to the three different heads, I'd be very interested to see if the Mind Flayer would be able to possess King Ghidorah and what would really happen in this matchup, because they are very similar. And the fact that they both have storms following them is very interesting. And I have to say, this matchup would be so intriguing to see in the movie. At the end of the day, I really do think that the Mind Flayer would not be able to possess King Ghidorah, especially with the ability to load up the lightning, that the Mind Flayer, first of all, probably wouldn't want to even try, and second of all, wouldn't be able to. I think if the Mind Flayer did, King Ghidorah heats up the lightning in order to use the gravity beams and would definitely make it not habitable for the Mind Flayer to even be in him in the first place. But I definitely do think that this would be a very interesting matchup. But I think King Ghidorah overall will not really win this fight, but will basically just make it to where the Mind Flayer won't even want to challenge him. I don't really know if King Ghidorah will be able to do any real damage to the Mind Flayer in the first place, even in the Upside Down, and then the Mind Flayer would just send him right back, saying he does not want to battle him at all. And I think that's how this fight would go down. But yeah, I have to say, this is a very interesting matchup, very good matchup, but it's just, there's too many questions, but overall, I think that the Mind Flayer wouldn't even want to mess with King Ghidorah. But I think if he did, and sent King Ghidorah to the Upside Down, and try to possess him, it just wouldn't work. And he wouldn't want to because of the lightning and how hot that gets and the charging ability. And I think that King Ghidorah would ultimately win this fight in that aspect and would basically not be able to be possessed and would just scare off the Mind Flayer, and he wouldn't want to mess with him at all. But make sure you let me know down below who you think would win this matchup or how you think this matchup would go down. I definitely think this would be a very interesting matchup. Two very similar creatures, except the Mind Flayer is just such a different creature from what I've done on this channel. But make sure you let me know down below what you think of this matchup, and thanks for watching.